My name is Ben, and on July 20th, 2019, I moved into this exact apartment, which I pay $3,200 a month for, on Sawtelle Boulevard in Los Angeles, and since then, I've had 3 different roommates, 5 different cars, and 3 different full-time jobs, and now I'm moving to San Diego, California. So I want to reflect on my time in LA with a few different points, and hopefully help you decide if you want to come to LA, leave LA, or live in LA.
Let's talk about cost of living. This is where I did most of my work when I wasn't at the office. It is also, of course, my bedroom, and my roommate and I both had a very similar master bedroom setup. So we had our own bathroom with the counter here. I had a walk-in closet, he had a sliding closet, and then I also got a setup right here where I stored all my photo and video gear. The total apartment size is almost 1,100 square feet, and the rent was $1,600 per person plus utilities. So it ended up being about $1,750 with Wi-Fi, but we had some pretty nice amenities. This bed doesn't seem that far from my desk, but when you zoom out, you realize it's kind of like living in LA. I live in West LA, and some of my best friends from college live in the Valley, which is only 18 and a half miles. But in LA, 18 and a half miles means a 1 to 2 hour drive, and getting to someone frustrated after sitting in traffic just isn't any fun. So I haven't seen those friends in literally 3 years. When you move to LA, choose wisely on where you live. If you live in Silver Lake, that's where you're gonna hang out. Don't expect to live in Culver City, make friends in East LA, and then go to the Valley for dinner sometimes. It just doesn't happen because the traffic is too insane even on the weekends. When it comes to making friends, like any city, doing social activities definitely helps. I joined a beach volleyball league and also did kickball on Wednesday nights, hence the cleats, and after the kickball games, we would go to the bar and do just a little bit of drinking. I don't drink often, I don't drink much, so I would actually leave early and didn't make that many friends from it, unfortunately. The other piece is it's hard to make one-on-one friends. When you go to a group setting, people will text and want to hang out in groups, do parties, go to activities and events together, but actually getting to know people one-on-one is a little bit more difficult because that means they actually have to care to drive 10 plus minutes to come see you or go to an event. There's a lot of good group activities in LA, but it's hard to find anything to do other than hike or maybe go to a concert or grab a drink. So making one-on-one friends is difficult, and whenever you see the opportunity to do so, take it, because the more friends you have, the more enjoyable any city will be. Dating in LA. I haven't done any of it in over a year, but all the apps make it so that you're everyone's second choice and everyone is your second choice, because there are so many people in LA that it's hard to justify picking just one person. You might find a great person, but you will also know that there are so many other people because the population is so big. Another thing with LA being a very big tourist attraction is there are a lot of people on the dating apps who are just here for a short amount of time, so you might match with them, be able to go out with them, and then turns out they live in a different state or a completely different country and they need a visa to get back here. So keep that in mind. Dating is still, like in any city, best when you're introduced by a friend or through a mutual activity, which is where those social groups help. But using the apps, there are so many options that a lot of people just swipe to swipe and not actually to go on dates. Take a look at this mattress and these boxes on the street. This is not curbside garbage pickup. These are things that people, the actual people living here, just leave on the street for the homeless to pick up because they know the homeless will pick it up. Sometimes the homeless try to move it and they just leave it literally in the middle of the sidewalk, just like that. I want to get to 7-Eleven and it says take a left on Venice Boulevard, so that's what I'm going to do. And I don't know how I feel about this carrying a camera or how I'd feel if I was walking here with a kid. Check it out. And in those tents are a bunch of mattresses, boxes, and things that people leave out on the streets for them. So we kind of give into it, and it's part of the culture here. What's scary is when I come down the stairs in the morning and there is somebody sleeping on the bottom of the stairs. I don't know if they're just there for themselves or if they want to take something. And more often than not, there are just crazy people yelling in the middle of the night into nowhere or yelling at people. And it's scary to park your car even a few blocks away from the apartment and then have to walk. So I'm not gonna miss that.
Well, here I am in San Diego 1 year later. I waited to edit this video because I wanted to see, will my thoughts on LA change? And they haven't. I love San Diego so much more. The people are much more relaxed here. There's way less traffic. The natural beauty of Los Angeles is also in San Diego. Not saying you should move to San Diego because I don't want it to turn into LA, but yeah, the reasons I left LA are all still true. And if you're thinking of leaving LA too, let me know your thoughts. Leave a comment below. Hope this video helped. Peace.